For me, Mozart 5 and Vieuxtemps 4 are linked in my life. When I was 10 years old, I started at the Curtis Institute of Music in Philadelphia. The last piece I worked on with my teacher, Clara Berkovich, before I went to Curtis was Vieuxtemps Concerto No. 4. And the first piece I worked on with Yasha Brodsky when they started at Curtis was Mozart's Concerto No. 5.
Hilary was always a curious mind and somebody who is always interested in finding couplings that are not off the beaten track.
I don't think I could put into words what it is about Mozart's music that's clearly Mozart. Somehow, it's just this recognizable thing. And I could say it's this combination of notes or it's this kind of ornamentation, but really, I'm sure other people did the same thing and it's Mozart that we recognize. So I really don't know. It's like there's this spark in the music that people pick up on but is invisible. Every time I play a Mozart concerto in particular, two things happen. Everyone is happy that whole week because people just seem to be happy working on Mozart. And I learn a new way to play Mozart because each orchestra comes from a different perspective on it. Vieuxtemps 4 is a great statement for violinists. It's just this beautiful lyrical work. It's got flashiness, but it always has a line. I think this Vieuxtemps concerto is one of the classics for violin. I think it really speaks to the violin's expressive qualities, and he uses the technical qualities that are most effective for the music. So it's really a very contagious musical piece that also shows you what the violin can do. I've played with this orchestra many times, and I've worked with Paavo many times, and there is no question during rehearsal that what we're focusing on is the music. It's just what sounds best, what do we need to work on to get it to sound better, and I just really love that. And the result of that is also when we get on stage, or when we're in front of the mics, we've built this understanding, and we can just play it.